Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, we are going to design the Tic-Tac-Toe game in Python using Tkinter framework. This is my second lecture on game development in Python tutorial. If you didn't watch first one, just pause the video and go and watch the first tutorial. The tutorial link is provided in the below description. So let's come back. And this is the output of the Tic-Tac-Toe game program. And what you're observing on seeing output. And here some text with bold. And here some 9 boxes, nothing but buttons with yellow color. And here some prompt symbol displaying as your game complete X wins. So let us discuss everything in detail. So what you're going to learn? In this tutorial, you're going to learn how to write text on window, how to use buttons on window, how to align widgets in a grid format, and text properties, nothing but bolding the text, font size and font families. Finally, how to display prompt message box. So how to write text on a window? We have a widget called label and have some arguments. Most commonly used arguments are window, text and font. Here is some basic example using label and using variable name equals to label and passing three arguments like window, text equals to Tic-Tac-Toe and font has two arguments. One is font family and another one is font size. And grid is nothing but our arrangement of widgets on a window. Syntax is variable dot grid row comma column. And nothing but it's arranging the particular label or particular widget in a matrix format on a window. So how to place buttons? We have a widget button with arguments like window, text, busy nothing but a background color. It's replaced as yellow. And FG is nothing but a foreground color, black nothing but a font color, and have width, height, font, command. Let us discuss command in the upcoming slides. So next one is how to display alert boxes. We have a class called message box in a Tkinter library. In a message box, we have many functions like show info, show error, show warning. In this program, we use show info for showing the message or prompt, like showing the message box. In the message box has two arguments, one is type of the message and another one is info of the message. And come back to the action trigger in Tkinter. Action trigger is nothing but to perform some action after clicking any of the widget. We have an argument called command in button to perform action when clicking any of the widget. Syntax command call and function call. After clicking any of the widget, the particular function will call. Let us understand some example. We have an example, and after clicking the command hello, it will display the hello Python. And finally, learning outcomes. By this lecture, you learn some widgets like label, button, message box, grid systems. So let us understand by executing the code in Python. So friends, I'm using PyCharm as my IDE. You can use any of the IDE, it's up to you. So this is the program for Tic-Tac-Toe game and I run this program. See, this is the output of Tic-Tac-Toe game. Here you're seeing some 9 boxes and some text on that. So let us understand everything in detail. So here is the label of label window text equals to Tic-Tac-Toe game. It's nothing but here. I'm giving a grid format as row 0 of column 0, means it is nothing but a first row and first column. Here the second one for row 1 and column 0, same column and second row. And here is the second row and here is first row and 0 row. And this is nothing but a grid system. And finally, here is the 9 buttons. And this is the syntax for 9 buttons. Button, text, background color yellow, foreground color black. Which already shown in slides. And for 9 buttons, we have 9 functions, click 1, click 2, and so on up to click 9. And these are the function logic. If a person clicked on click 1, generally for playing Tic-Tac-Toe game, we require 2 members, one player 1 and player 2. Player 1, I initially the player 1 turn as X and play for first one, so I use turn equals to 1. And initially, all the 9 buttons are empty. See, this button 1 of text is nothing but for getting the text of a button. initially first one is empty, right? So it's the if loop will executes and goes to the if turn equals to 1. Initially if turn is 1, then turn will be initialized to 2 and button of text equals to x. So let us like this. So now turn is 2. If we click on this one, nothing will happen because if button is not empty. So if you click on second one here in second program, button 2 is empty but turn is 2, so button 2 text equals to 0, nothing but like that. If you keep on performing like that for every buttons, for every function we use some check function, nothing but for checking whether which player will win either x or 0. Here is the code or any logic for check function. Here I'm using 9 buttons. Here is up to you. You can directly use these buttons for understanding. I initialize 9 buttons and then checking. These buttons are nothing but button 1, button 2, button 3, and so on up to 9 buttons. If here is the logic, if b1 equals to b2 and b1 equals to b3, nothing but if three have same text, then obviously x will win or o will win. Like that, this is the basic functionality or basic logic of Tic-Tac-Toe game. Finally, if any of the person wins, then I call another function called win function and passing the particular player. And this is the win function. And enhance the game complete, the particular player wins. So let us understand here something like oops. Completed. Game complete, X wins. And if you click on OK, then it automatically close the windows.destroy function, which means it used to close the program and complete it. Well, suppose what happened if a match tried or draw. Let's see that one also. Oops, sorry. See guys, match tried and try again. So how this executes? Actually, there are 9 buttons tried. So I initialize a flag. If flag is 10, that means if you're crossing 9, then execute this function called messagebox.showInfo. In that, I prompt a message called message try and try again. If you click on OK, then it will be destroyed. Guys, this is the basic functionality of Tic-Tac-Toe game in Python using Tkinter framework. I hope you enjoy this, guys. So that's it for today's lesson. Thank you guys. If you like my video, thumbs up and subscribe me. In the next lesson, we're going to discuss something new game called Scrambling Words. Bye, catch you in the next lecture.